Now, coming up next on Golden Grace, the man who bills himself as the last madman of rock and roll. He and his friends have put on some of the greatest performances of all time. It's next on Golden Grace. Welcome back to the Golden Greats. This time we're dealing with the wild men of rock and roll, and the man who heads up this next group falls into that category, certainly. When I first worked with them on the old television series Where the Action Is, they were sort of like the musical Marx Brothers. We'd give them an assignment, maybe a song, whatever, a little piece of action. You never knew what was going to happen. This man was actually asked to leave his high school for riding his motorcycle through the halls of the school. And that was just the start of what's been a wild and wonderful career. There's nobody like the last madman of rock and roll, Paul Revere and the Raiders. This is one of those three-corner hats that Paul Revere and the Raiders still throw out in the audience. They see what you look like here. And looking good, my man. Now, talk about stage pranks. How about these guys coming up? They're famous for wearing things like this, emblems and chains and all that stuff, old baseball hats, and they get into a lot of little friendly fights with their audience. They grew up in New York City, where they soon became bored with high school, and they dropped out to pursue the hardcore punk rock scene. And an early version of the group was the Young and Useless. Following their flirtation with punk, they became involved with the emerging rap scene, and their debut album, License to Ill, has been certified as the fastest-selling debut in the history of their label. Now, are these rappers Run DMC, the Beastie Boys, or the Fat Boys? We'll find out when we come back for more Golden Greats.